National regimental bonding.
Men are definitely bonded and brought closer together in the pub. It's where friendships are formed. It's where you tell your mates what you really think of them.
Boys will be boys. You put any group of men together and they will behave like children. And you could say that about students. You could say it about... And you could then move on to football fans. You can move on to rugby fans. And then you... Way, way down the line, you've got paras. I mean, Lord only knows what they get up to behind closed doors.
You ready?
Got.
Stapling beer mats to each other's heads.
I don't know how the stapling came about. I just came into work one day and everyone had puncture wounds all over their heads.
Once, a Marine came into the Pegasus and decided to prove he had more balls than the paras.
Fight.
By stapling his bits to the table.
And then he realised he couldn't get the fucker back out again. So he's had to wrench his bollocks off the table. Cut it off. But you know, you can't really cut someone's bollocks off. That's a bad thing.
No one really wanted to do that anymore because apparently you're a girl if you want your head stapled. So he moved on to the next one, which is firing pool balls at the tops of each other's heads. As hard and as fast as they could.
It's hard not to feel a swelling of national pride for these fine young men. God bless the Parachute Regiment, and God bless the Pegasus. A thought for the good old Cornish fisherman, risking his life in one of the most dangerous professions in the world. Also, we can have fish with our chips. They're a very tough bunch, and the boys in Newlyn are no exception. Smack bang opposite the harbour, the swordfish has been a fisherman's friend for over 150 years. It's their pub. And the first stop for any hard-bitten mariner determined to get drunk after a cruel week at sea.
Fishermen's pubs seem to be an extension of the sea. And walking into one of their pubs, it's almost like they look at you as if, how did you walk into this ship? No, it's not a ship, it's a pub. You're not on the ship anymore, you're in a pub. They don't want you in it, it's like you've walked into their home.
So landlord Pete Bell has his work cut out.
I've been here 10 years, been involved in it in 10 years. I've seen a lot of changes in it. It is a good old pub. It's a rough pub. You have the odd instance where people throw glasses about and or just break them on the floor for something to do.
The boats are due in any moment, so it's time for the staff at the Swordfish to put the finishing touches to the pub so it can get trashed again over the coming hours.
Landing day is their most crucial day. That's the first day they come in and they all just want to get totally rat-arsed.
You can't wait to come in. You walk in and your first pint is like nectar.
You'll never taste beer as good.
It's like a big sort of glow comes into you and that beer tastes good.
Hard-nut Cornish fishermen need hard drinks and they don't come any harder than the Newlyn Knockout.
It involves vodka, drambuie and absinthe.
Two or three of those and then it's time to go home.
In goes the vodka. Nice, warm and drink this is.
We've always had a desire as drinkers to experiment and there've been some quite nice drinks come out of it in the end, but not many.
I suppose if you have been out in the cold and the wet, you want something that you're going to feel. You want something you're going to taste. You're probably going to want something you can chew. Well, you know, there's vodka, drambuie, gin, Domestos. They've got the lot in them.
All the best, lads. Cheers, Dave.
These boys can certainly handle their booze, but there is one thing that's guaranteed to turn their stomachs.
French. Not a good one in my book, I'm afraid. I mean, I've had to throw them out of here several times when they get out of order. There. I don't like them, basically. I don't mind saying it, you know.
Je t'aime.
The French even have the gall to come into the Swordfish and speak, well, French. Something that Pete Bell refuses to put up with.
You're making everybody uneasy because they don't know what's going on and you're not speaking a word of ruddy English. And I go, no, I've had enough. How do you go?
If you're out all day trying to catch a cod and some Frenchman whistles past and pulls it out your net for you, you're not going to be in the best of moods.
I mean, I've heard some horrendous stories of when they've been at sea and they've fired flares into the back of the French boats and all, you know, the ramming and things like that.
Once, a French boat ripped through the nets of a Newlyn trawler, and afterwards the crew made the mistake of coming into the Swordfish for a pint.
And somebody came up and he said, you know that boat that took you? Yeah, he's in. Is he? But fuck. I stood guard and they went down with spanners and hammers and went aboard this Frenchman and the crew run. They ran.
One of the fishermen took the grinder to the boat.
They went in the wheelhouse, smashed it to bits. Everything, it's all, everything, radars, a lot.
With such a welcome, you'd have thought that the French would have learnt not to venture into the Swordfish, but it seems some nations can't be told.
I've had an instance here when there was a load here and one of them went to pull a knife out of his boot.
Everybody's looking at one another, thinking, what should we do with this bastard? And it, I think there was three of us in line, passed them on, and the last one was the door, and he went through.
Then there was the small matter of who would pay for the damaged door.
I had to take the money off him. Never had a lot on him, really.
The boats were told to get out of the harbour and not come back. It was one hell of a day.
You'd think the fishing folk of Newlyn would blame their tough behaviour on too much grog. You'd be wrong.
Full moon, yeah, the full moon, that's a frightening old time, I think, anyway.
When we've had a particularly heavy-duty night, whether it's been extra noisy or extra boisterous, and they've got the music loud and they're just generally guzzling and misbehaving.
Sometimes it can be frightening. I hate it. I must admit, I hate it, and I'd shut my pub if I could. I'd just shut it up.
Having banished the French with the convenient excuse that the moon made them do it, the wild men of the Swordfish are left to enjoy each other's company. So say goodbye, but not au revoir, to Newlyn and the lunatic fishermen of the Swordfish. From picturesque Cornwall, we journey to Hartcliffe in Bristol. A modern council estate, until the locals rioted a few years back and reduced it to this. This, though, was not the mindless violence of your average riot, for the good people of Hartcliffe had the sense to leave one building standing, their beloved boozer, the Hartcliffe Inn.
I watched the riots from my... and I was having a beer while I watched it.
It's a tough estate.
Part of this estate, some of it's crap, shit.
If somebody comes out and say this pub, down to the off licence on the way home and he's wobbling, seven times out of ten they get mugged.
A community pub as tough as the Hartcliffe requires the hardest of landlords. An ex-regular, Nigel Templer, seems to have the right kind of experience.
I've been in bike clubs and I've been in jail. I've been done for assault on police, on, you know, on ordinary citizens. When I was, I mean, the previous landlords, they tell you what I was like when I come in here. I was the same. But don't do as I do, do as I say. That's me, you know. Oh, it's terrible. I'm ashamed of it. Well, not really, but it's just a phase that you go through.
After taking over the boozer 9 years ago, Nigel set about tackling the ruffians.
What is he, about 6'5", 6'6", about 3 foot across? He can look after himself.